So I have here my 3/8 spade bit. That's what the manufacturer recommends, the size hole for a 1032 insert to be drilled. I'm going to drill that in now. I have a little dot there. And I'm going to drill a hole. I'm going to put my driver. You can see my driver here. I'm going to put that in my battery drill. I have the insert. There's a top side to the insert. That's the bottom. It's flush. And in here it has those two indentations, two grooves, so you can use the tool to insert this. So I'm going to lay it on there so it gets in there properly. I'm going to find so this sits in there. I'm going to line it up so it stays straight, and I'm going to start driving it in. I'm just going to bring it right to where it needs to be. It's important that you hold this straight, because if you don't, it's going to start chipping away at the grooves, because brass is a soft metal. I just have a piece of aluminum here with a hole in it, and if I wanted to attach that, I have a 1032 screw here. Yeah, this is a long screw. And it might be too long, but I don't know. We'll see. And I'm just gonna tighten it up to show you that you can tighten down on that very strong. An amazing insert. So there's two ways you can put this insert in. You can do it with the manufacturer's driving tool, which goes right into a drill. Or if you don't have the driving tool, you can just use your fastener or a hex cap screw. Install the hex cap screw all the way in to the insert, and take the insert and start and get it started. Grab your ratchet and drive it in. Okay, we're almost there, not there 100% yet. Okay, that's pretty good. Okay, I've driven in the insert with a hex cap screw. I'm going to now back this off and take the screw out. And you can see there that the insert is in place. Now, a lot of people have said to me, well, you got the insert in backwards. Fact is, it's not in backwards. It's incorrectly. Each manufacturer manufactures these different. This is an easy lock product. This is their system for installing with their tool. But you don't need the tool to install one of these, as I just showed you. Thanks for watching.